Northern Siberia. Its very name evokes some of the world's toughest people, battling winter's harshest wrath.
Northern Siberia is legendary for its intense winters and remote, inaccessible areas. At certain times of year, villages can be completely disconnected from one another.
In 2015, researchers make a grim discovery at a place known as Zeleny Yar. They uncover an unusual-looking burial site in the frozen ground. Inside, they find a body wrapped in what appears to be tree bark.
When you come across something this unique, so many questions start racing through your mind.
Who is this person? Why are they wrapped in a shroud?
A find like this is quite rare. We're talking about Siberia. This place is very remote.
Finding a body like this is pretty unusual. Why would someone wrap a body in bark?
To get some answers, they transport the body to a lab for testing.
When we find a body wrapped in something, we recognize that there's a certain amount of care that was given to the preparation of the body. There was a certain amount of respect that was being paid to this individual.
The size of the shroud leads them to believe it could be a teenager. When researchers delicately cut open the shroud, they discover a hidden layer of reindeer fur.
Could this bark cloth and reindeer fur hint at some special burial ritual?
Below the fur, they make another strange discovery. Carefully placed upon the body, covering the face, chest, abdomen, and groin, are four large, flat pieces of copper.
This burial custom has never been found in graves in Siberia.
Removing the copper pieces from the face, they realize it's not a teenager, but the eerie mummified body of a young boy.
It's astonishing to look into the perfectly preserved face of one that was so young.
The boy died when he was only 7 years old, around the year 1250, during the medieval period. But as researchers continue their excavation, they make an astounding discovery. They find 88 separate hidden graves in the frozen ground, all buried between the 8th and 13th centuries.
It's actually pretty amazing. This boy's grave was part of a whole necropolis. But without any distinctive artifacts, we still don't know who these people were.
As researchers uncover the bodies, another strange anomaly comes to light. Out of the 88 corpses, they only find one adult female.
It's hard to understand just why they didn't bury their women in the same gravesite.
This discovery is really strange. Maybe they had a completely different ritual for burying the women.
In some cultures, soldiers are buried separately from the rest of the population. So it's possible that there were no women in this burial simply because they were separated from the soldiers.
Some of the other bodies are also buried with copper plates, and some are partially mummified. But out of the 88 bodies found, the boy in the birch bark shroud is in the most advanced state of mummification. Beneath his body, still wrapped inside the bark shroud, researchers discover an axe, a knife, and multiple rings.
Certainly, he could have worn the rings, and he could have used the knife and used the axe in his daily life.
Some have suggested that the copper plates found on his body might have been some kind of rudimentary armor.
The copper pieces might also be symbolic of armor, but as a metal, it's far too soft to offer much protection. If he were a young warrior, the copper plating would have been no match for an iron sword.
If he suffered a traumatic death, you might expect to find evidence of injuries like broken bones or lacerations on the skin. But in fact, there are no puncture wounds, there's no evidence of slashing anywhere on the body.
Ancient mummification techniques remove key organs from the body. But CT scans of the boy reveal his brain and internal organs are still intact.
In some cultures, only the elite are mummified, like the famous mummies found in Egypt.
Even if he wasn't a young warrior, he was clearly someone of high status.
If he and many of the other bodies weren't mummified on purpose, how could it have occurred?
Copper has antimicrobial properties, which means that bacteria have a really tough time surviving on that surface. The copper plates may have slowed the decay in the areas they were placed.
Plus, the boy was buried in tundra conditions where snow covers the ground 10 months of the year. The cold temperatures also slow down decay.
In extreme environments like high altitudes and polar regions, it's possible to find bodies that have been accidentally mummified. This is why scientists call it accidental or natural mummification. But they still don't understand why they buried their dead this way and why in this location.
Whoever they were, they must at some point have lived close by if their dead are buried there.
Could the nearest town of Salikard, 20 miles away, hold clues to the lost identity of the 88 Siberian graves?
The town wasn't established until the 16th century, so these bodies predate the town by hundreds of years.
This is a huge necropolis that has attracted burials for centuries, and yet archaeologists haven't found any evidence of a contemporary settlement nearby.
The Yamal Peninsula has been home to the Nanettes and Conti people for centuries. They've migrated and herded reindeer through this northern tundra for generations.
The Nanettes are a nomadic people, and so archaeologists wonder whether the boy might still be a distant ancestor.
When researchers compare the boy's DNA to the Nanettes people, they discover a genetic connection. But strangely, the Nanettes don't have an oral history of the massive Zeleni Yar burial site. Could a rare burial practice of the local Nanettes people reveal a hidden connection to the ancient necropolis?
Perhaps there are cultural similarities that could shed light on why they were buried here. The memory of who these people were has disappeared. But maybe some of their traditions have endured.
In Nanette culture, when someone dies, there is a tradition to punch a hole through the bottom of a metal pot or bucket. The idea is that the cauldron itself is broken, it can no longer be used in this world, but it will be intact and whole, ready for use in the afterlife.
So it is possible that the pieces of copper found on these bodies are just another example of that tradition.
But if the people buried here do have relations to the Nanettes community, researchers still wonder, what is the significance of this place? Zeleni Yar, the area where the necropolis was found, is situated by a river on a floodplain island. And it's the highest point in the area for miles around.
This location is where two rivers meet, and the higher ground would have been less prone to flooding.
It's really interesting that all of the bodies are positioned facing the river.
Usually when you find a group of bodies arranged according to some geographical feature, like a river, it indicates that there's some significance there. Like maybe this river is sacred.
In many cultures, rivers and bodies of water hold special significance. And in fact, there are lots of myths and legends around crossing rivers into the afterlife.
But with no written records, the mummified boy, his incredible grave goods, and the 88 other graves are all that's left to bear silent witness to a mysterious people.
We don't know what happened to these people, but the preservation of this boy is giving him a second life in our world.